Sitting here with Rick Smith, President and CEO of Tri-Counties Bank. Full disclosure, I do a little voice work for their commercial, so we're here more to talk about Rick and how he got to where he is today, because that's what interests people a lot. I mean, you're the CEO of a bank, Rick. You started out as a high school quarterback. You went to Sac State. You grew up in a family where sports was very important. How did that... We talked about on air a little bit about how your sister, one of the great athletes in Sacramento history, Karen Smith, how did that competitive juice play into the business world for you?
Well, it certainly does. I mean, number one, I think sports in general makes you think like a team member and makes you win and lose as a team. And I think in business, most businesses I find that are successful are not built around one individual. They're built around a group of people.
Yeah.
And so from that perspective, it's important to play as a team. And see, the other part of it is winning is fun.
Yeah.
And losing is not fun. And so... that's really what about business is. It's about winning and losing and making good judgments along the way.
Right. You know, the banking industry as a whole has been kind of beat up over the last few months in a big way, not just stock price, but just in terms of overall image and the layoffs in New York and everything else. And I know there's a big difference between New York and Chico, where you're based. But just for some youngster who might be in college or in high school thinking of a banking career, what would you say to that person about the ultimate rewards of being in banking?
Banking is a great industry. The neat part about banking is that there's so many jobs within the banking industry, whether they're technology jobs, whether they're accounting jobs, whether they're sales positions, whether they're selling securities, or whether they're making loans. There's just so much diversity in the industry, and it's just a vital industry to the economy, and we're finding that out now.
Right.
When money stops moving, and that's what banks do, is exchange money. When money stops moving, the economy falters, and so that's what we're experiencing and living with.
And do you take kind of an internal sense of pride when you see a big project going up on a corner somewhere of what had been just dirt before, and you know that your loans help make that happen?
Particularly for a community bank, because what a community bank does, I think, better than any other type of institution is we get to know our customers.
Right.
And we take... a level of risk based on that knowledge, and we've seen business after business start from just an idea in a garage and turn into a real success story, and there's a great reward for being able to help them along the way.
All right, let's run through some of the questions I like to ask my CEOs here. Your first summer job?
First summer job was washing trucks out in Roseville, cement trucks.
Wow.
It was a real fun job.
How old were you then? Were you in high school?
I was in high school, and They're not bad to wash in the summer, but in the winter when it's really cold, it was a little miserable.
Oh, you did it not just summer. You did it into the school year, huh?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Number two, the strangest job you've ever had, the one that just sticks out is, how did I end up doing that?
I worked night shift at 7-Eleven.
Oh, my goodness.
You see plenty of strange in that job.
Yeah. Any gunplay?
Thought so one time. I was lucky to survive the night.
Did you? Okay.
I didn't keep that job that long.
What is the one piece of technology you could not live without?
Cell phone.
Yeah.
I think anymore, I mean, you can't live without a PC, but I travel enough.
Well, your
now.
Cell phone can be your PC.
The cell phone does pretty much everything for me.
And that's important for Rick, because you have how many branches?
57 branches from Wairika to Bakersfield,
yeah.
So we're spread out all over.
And you visit them somewhat regularly. I mean, obviously you're not going
to. Certainly try to,
What's your favorite business publication? Whether it's a newspaper or a magazine or a website, is there one piece?
I'm a little spoiled because I use the Bloomberg News on my desk, so I have a little, you know, that's an expensive way to get the news, but it gets all of the news, so I'm a little spoiled. That and the Wall Street Journal.
Yeah, okay. What about a role model or mentor? Is there someone who kind of, you know, took you under his or her wing early on and led you down the right path?
Well, my father-in-law was the banker, and I took over for him, so... It'd be I'd be remiss not to say that it was my father-in-law.
Yeah.
He taught me a great deal about banking, and it gave me a great opportunity.
That's great. And number six, the most expensive business lesson you ever learned.
Well, I've learned how to go broke. I was in the produce business, and one day we had lent money to a restaurant chain that went broke. And we found out that day that doesn't work very well. So I learned a great deal about banking that day. Because when you lend money unsecured and they can't pay you back, it's a terrible feeling. We survived it and we didn't go broke, but It was no better lesson learned that I've ever had than that day.
A kick in the gut, huh?
Yeah, you feel that one. It runs right through your body.
Is that when you left produce and went into banking?
Well,
that would be.
They're both green things, I guess. Yeah. But they're both interesting businesses.
And what about work-life balance? I know you got a family at home, and you know, is it close to what you wish it could be?
Well, it's yes. I mean, I'm very, very pleased to have a wonderful family that I am able to spend time with and watch them grow up and play sports and enjoy life. And you always want more time for that. But at the same time, I don't dislike going to work. It's a lot of joy in working in the banking business, and I work with a bunch of great people, so that makes a big difference.
And that's probably a big difference working in a Chico versus a New York City. I mean,
absolutely.
You can do that. I mean, the high school football or baseball field is probably a block or two from the bank, right?
Well, it is. Last Friday night was Chico had the hometown rivalry game, and it's at Chico State, and there's 3,000 people there, and it's an experience.
It's Friday Night Lights.
It's Friday Night Lights, and that's a fun way to live.
You can
live on a dime if people are worried about, you know, their money's going away, but you can live cheap and enjoy life, too.
Oh, sure you can, especially with high school sports
Absolutely.
Around. So, well, Rick, congratulations on all your success. Hope Tri-County continues to do well, and hope you come back. We'll chat again when things are turning up.
I hope so.
Rick Smith, thanks very much, Rick, for joining us.
Okay.